Official attendance 54,984. Greg Anderson under pressure with the left foot. Take your pick, Collingwood. Well, they had three chances. And Crisisca with a hip and shoulder on Terry Danaher.
Yeah, just got away with that.
7-goal margin. Terry Danaher with his 2 goals today. Salmon over the top. Grenfell held on to long. And still out of play.
Interesting to see what Kevin Sheedy does now. Dacos going down to a forward pocket with that cramp. Kicker will follow him. Now, if he wants kicker to stay in the play, he's going to bring him up and make a change very quickly. Otherwise, he's losing his best playmaker.
Dead right. He's easily Essendon's best player at the moment, kicker. And he's now in the back pocket, so we'll have to move him. Gary Pert to the centre of the ground. McMullen dropped the mark. It's a difficult one, though. Chris Danaher receives from Buick. Back to Buick, who looks as though he's hurt himself. Goes to ground. Socket off the ground at the centre. Stasevich has been too quick and too good. Gets in a quick hand pass. Taken by Thompson. Anderson caught. Shrugs the tackle. Back it came to Flood. Now on to Madden. Mark drop. Wanganeen hasn't looked fit. Oh, brilliant play by Wanganeen. Was it out? Yes, it was. So it'll be a throw-in.
Oh, risk it. Yeah, the Essendon runner's been out there. He's already been down to kick it. They're about to instrument some changes. See what happens.
8 kicks, 4 handballs for Gavin Wanganeen. But as Peter McKenna said, not fully fit. Well, there's Dacos and Kickett still in the forward pocket for Collingwood. Surely Kickett's got to get into the play. He's been the big winner in the second half for Essendon. His Bomber Thompson has been reasonable today. He's kicked the centre half forward long. And Richardson, Flood's got to attack it hard. He does, did well. Snaps for goal, kicks it. Through. 12-9, 18-9. Flood kicks his first goal.
Yes, he's been very, very quiet. He's found the pace and mobility of Christian, I should say, far too good. This occasion, though, with Richardson spoiling back towards play rather than out to the outer side, gave Flood the opportunity to mop up, and he did that well.
Much better play by the Essendon forward line then. Only 6 goals the difference now, still 18 minutes, so, you know, 3 quick ones, you never know what could happen. Although the task ahead of Essendon here, certainly Collingwood have been much the better side. Here's McMullen trying to force them forward, he does. Crisisca raced at it, punched it away. Lehman. Scott Russell put his teammate under pressure. That was Williams. He's lost it in the tackle.
Well,
goes in to get it again. Danaher. Now McMullen. He can kick it long. Terry Danaher versus Gaffer. Gaffer the spoiling tactics. Wanganeen goes to ground. Here's a chance for a goal. Terry Danaher kicks a goal that they throw.
It's a good bounce. Grenfell, he's got to kick this. Drop punt. Go. Through. They're back in it. 14-9, 18-9. And suddenly, this game has come alive again.
Yes, and you wonder whether the move of Wallace off the ground has made some difference here. There's certainly been a lift out of the centre very quickly. Long, but Grenfell has had a very quiet day. Just 4 kicks, 5 handballs. That's his best possession so far.
All of a sudden, we have a contest. The Bomber supporters finding voice. 4 goals the margin. Can they get it out the centre again? Tons of time, just under 18 minutes. There's the big punch away. Mark Thompson, the quick kick. Michael Long, is that a free kick?
Yeah.
Umpire said no. Christian taps it on. The race is on for the ball. Chris Danaher. Now Manson, he can't pick it up. He kicks it straight to Gary O'Donnell. Greg Anderson, wide, David Flood. Flood, no mark. Gaffer shuffles it on. Oh, the Collingwood players under pressure now. Richardson to the half-back line, and this game has really gained in tempo all of a sudden.
How could there possibly not be a free kick to Michael Long there?
Madden's given Essendon a lift here. Tackle Rossi put on 5 minutes ago was inspirational.
Terrific.
Now Spawn from 50 metres. Salmon and Pert and are behind. 14-10, 18-9. Swans had 13-5, so it hasn't been too bad. Williams beat him in the duel early. Went back to the defence, and now he's in the forward line. And with Dacos injured in the pocket, they've lost something here, Collingwood. Oh, good mark. Under pressure.
Free kick or mark. Take your pick.
Krasiska.
Won't hurt to slow it down a bit.
From half-back. Been useful today. One of the link players. About to go short for Stasevic. Harvey against him. Now Harvey. Lehman tries to put the tackle on him. Long in the front spot. Lays it off for Wanganeen. Tackled by Rowe at the back. Now Grenvold tries to pave it out. Rowe stops it. Still stops it. They look for a free kick and they get it for Thompson. Against Rowe. Seven in the goal square. Thompson short. Here's a chance. Madden in kicking distance.
Well, his two goals in that first quarter were good ones. This is going to be such a vital one.
Can the champion kick the goal? 50 metres out where he'll kick it from. Drop punt. It's close. Kurt did well. It's been held also by Samuel. And well played, Gary Kurt. And maybe in the end, Paul Samuel should have tried to take it himself.
Certainly could have. In fact, you're right, Bruce. He was holding on to Kurt's jumper.
Forward pocket. All of a sudden, Essendon can sense there's some sort of chance when they were way out of it. Socket up the ground by Manson. And it rolls over the line. We have 15 minutes and 12 seconds of play left in the game. Tons of time. But the Magpies stopping Essendon coming home. Matt taps it down. Grenvold. Hand pass to O'Donnell. He's on his left foot. O'Donnell the short pass. Buick. Open goal coming up. Darren Buick bang. Slams it through for a great goal.
To be all over Red Rover is certainly a contest now. Madden in the centre again. O'Donnell is tackled by Morwood. Chris Danaher might have been a bit lucky in the end.
Very lucky.
Well, they penalised Rowe the other side. That's a very similar one.
Very lucky. He was hanging onto that ball.
Well, next goal so important here. Collingwood just needs it to steady it and make it a good thing. If Essendon get it, it's anyone's game. Here's Lehman from the centre square. It's the first time Collingwood's been in attack for ages. It should be repelled, though. McMullen on his left foot. Long's outnumbered. Good mark. Graham Wright has come back from nowhere.
He might have bruised the other buddy. He's all right.
So Wright, with Tony Francis also injured. You can see here he's hobbling. So Collingwood, the walking wounded a little at the moment, towards McEwen as he pushed. Rowe off the ground. Harvey. And suddenly it's Collingwood that are looking a little sluggish and slow. Well, Wright took it off Buick, though, and quickly plays on. Manson in the front spot. Kickett still in the back pocket, which is extraordinary when you think about it. There's Morwood, Rowe. Collingwood needs a goal here. Manson, Dacos, sandwiched. Oh, chance now, left foot. Misses Watson are behind. Well, Ross, can you believe that Kickett's still standing down there getting cold?
Well, I know the other thing that Kevin Sheedy would be worried about, Bruce, is if the ball does come down quickly in a tight situation, he'd want a skillful player on Dacos, so he's going to rob Peter to pay Paul in some respects, but I'd still take the punt and move him up the ground.
Derek Kickett has found Darren Buick. Buick looking for an option. He should kick long. Now he's got a loose man, bad checking Collingwood. Bomber Thompson. Will he have a bounce? No, he brings it in short. Terry Danaher trying to trap it. Oh, too slow to get rid of it, Terry. Collingwood players lying over the ball and it's brought into the pack. There'll be a bounce. Centre of the ground. What a game now.
I'd definitely move kick it now because Dacos is in a spot of bother.
Well, plenty happening off the ball too with this bounce. Madden goes early. Spawn looks for a free kick. Didn't get it. Was a bit unlucky. Russell's kicked the half forward. Watson, well played. Kept his feet very well against Fox. Well, Kickett should take it. He does. Plays on. Swings it wide to Danaher. Swings it to Harvey. It's He's got to take a chance and run with it. Buick's running into the centre on his own. Spawn's the target. Has it got the legs? It has. Spawn takes the mark at centre wing. Buick short. Wright tries to hold Spawn up. He should handle. Doesn't. Goes long. Salmon, front spot. No crumbers for Essendon. Taken by Richardson. Buick's going to have to chase hard. Wright with him. Buick goes for it. Wright goes to ground. Spawn will be there if he wants him. Buick goes to Chris Danaher, hits him lace out. And Danaher from the centre square goes across.
He's got a loose man in Ian McMullen. McMullen the long kick. Wallace at the back. Oh, Dean Wallace not in the contest is taking the mark. Gaffer.
Can you believe Kevin Sheehy's taken Terry Danaher off and put Dean Wallace on?
Unbelievable. Danaher kicked 3 goals, a couple in this term. Wallace back on the ground unless he's injured. That's the only thing.
The way he looked at the coach's box, he's not injured, I can tell you.
Well, if he has been taken off the ground, that is the worst decision you'd ever see. Oh, kick it sensational. Spawn. What a game now. Salmon. He's got McMullen. He's got Buick. He goes for Buick. Buick. Wanganeen should kick it. He held onto it far too long. Renbold from 40 metres. Straightens up. And he has missed. Oh. Mistakes being made.
It's a great effort there by Tony Francis to chase Wanganeen and bring him down. Great effort. He's hobbling, but he made the effort for his team that could save the game.
15, 11, 18, 10. Wanganeen cramped.
And still, Sheedy persists with kick it down the back line. Dacos can't move.
Pert short to Lehman. Collingwood is hanging on. And Essendon is challenging strongly. Lehman to centre wing, Morwood and Thompson. Thompson at the back, missed by Chris Danaher. Russell's kicked to centre wing again. Here's Watson and Fox. Manson, oh gee, Fox and hard. Well played, Manson. He's awkward. Spawn versus Morwood. Free kick going to
Anthony Danaher
against
or Spawn?
Anthony Danaher. Kickett's looking for it at centre-half back. Danaher takes his opponent on and McEwen goes short to Chris Danaher, who's played pretty well. Greg Anderson on the run. Left foot to centre-half forward. Wallace. Ben Hell. A chance. Buick running for him. So's Madden. Wallace's kick for Buick. He'll take it. Great mark. A beauty by Buick.
Yes, it was a very good mark. Yeah, the taller player, Kosisa, coming back onto him, almost shearing the ball off his face, but he did that very well.
Kick 4 goals, Buick.
It had to be a good kick, and it was. It hit him on the chin, might have saved him.
He's usually an outstanding kick. This to bring Essendon within 2 goals. Drop punt by Buick's a beauty.
A happy man. Graham Wright, oh, smothered by Thompson. Gary O'Donnell's been excellent. McMullen around the corner, he's got a man, Buick, has he lifted? Buick, oh, loose men everywhere. Kieran Spawn, get onto the right foot, he does, and he goes short. Wanganeen has marked at 60 metres. Magpie's under enormous pressure. Gavin Wanganeen, there's no one back in the square. He's going short. Long, Michael Long has marked 30 metres from goal. Don't tell me this is going to be one of the great comebacks of all time. The Essendon supporters jubilant.
You talk about cricket being a funny game and how quickly that can change. Footy these days changes very, very quickly. Collingwood look home and hosed.
Michael Long, a pressure kick. A real pressure kick. 40 metres from goal. Michael Long kicks and he has missed the madness. 8 minutes, just over 8 minutes of play left. There's Kevin Sheedy. And the scoreboard shows 10 points the margin. The Magpies still in the box seat.
Pert to himself. Handballs to Stasevich. Should kick it across to Krasiska, and he does.
Yeah, good play.
Like a game of chess, that pun for Collingwood. To Williams, who's been quiet since half-time. Christian works for him. Short. Fox holds him up. Watson's loose. Collingwood with some loose men. Into the centre. A mark to McGuan. And 50 metres against Flood. and this could be damaging. It could be the blow that sees Collingwood home, because McGuan will come right up to within 30 metres of the goal.
You'll see this again. Flood. Very late. You see a lot of that, so you wonder whether 50 metres really is required in that situation.
So McGuan from, well, about 40 metres in the end. And Collingwood need this. You'd fancy they'd win if he kicks this with 7.5 minutes remaining. They lead by 10 points. They've managed just 1 point in this final term, whilst Essendon has kicked 5 goals, 4. McGuan from 40 metres, drop cut, good kick, goal. 19-10 to 16-12, McGuan with his first.
Yes, we had a late start in 91 with some groin injuries and what have you, but he's certainly been effective. See this infringement once again. It is late, and that's where this 50-metre penalty is so severe. 15 metres or something of that nature is perhaps more effective.
Back to the centre. That might stop the run on. Fox. Flood again caught behind. Renvall looking for someone to give it to. He's found Simon Matt, the chip pass. In towards half forward. Courage shown there by Graham Wright. Buick with pace. Oh, he put the pressure on. Good play, Buick. Gary O'Donnell's got Michael Long on his own, and he's found him. Long will play on. Sprints clear. Oh, Wegmedine's fallen over. Now he's got it, the youngster. Kicks a goal and is missed.
I'll tell you what, Pete, he recovered so very well then as he went down. He still scooped the ball in very cleverly.
3 points to the Wanganeen in unison. Ross, great minds.
We've been waiting for that one.
Think alike. But Essendon still with a chance. They're still playing better than Collingwood, and that gives them the chance. Pert with his experience. Christian his target, and David Flood 5 metres behind him. He's been one of the best today, Christian.
You really should never be able to kick out from fullback like that and have an option so easy.
Shane Maud's his target. Bomber Thompson at the back. Oh, good mark, Maud in the front.
It's a critical mark, that is.
See what Collingwood's doing here. They're playing possession football, slowing it up. Pinpoint accuracy. Maud looks for Manson. Harvey went early. Fox to get back on it. Francis to put the pressure on. And he does effectively. And Fox was pressurised into a poor handball. And without pointing the finger at specific players, there are about 3 Essendon players today that just haven't been up to it and have made a difference.
You're dead right, Bruce. Man at the back, taps it down. Mark Harvey, they've got to bring it back, Essendon, towards the centre. Not out round the boundary line, they've got to take the punt and bring it to the centre at all occasions. 5 minutes of play left. Very difficult now. They've got to score one very quick. Got Terry Danner on the bench. He's unbelievable. He livened up that forward line. Dean Mollis had a disastrous game. The 3 quarters has been brought back to the forward pocket. Well, we're not the coach, but what about, why would you do it?
What about Derek Kickett still sitting back there? You're trailing by 15 points and he's nowhere near the footy.
Well, here's Danaher. Gary O'Donnell's gone wide. Kieran Spawn. Oh, he's trying to beat too many. Should have kicked the ball, Kieran Spawn, at this time. Oh, well done, Wanganeen. Strong bump. Long kick. Oh, it bounces. Perth, Salmon. Dodges. Should give it across to Michael Long. He does. Essendon still fighting. Can they get up? 17-13 plays 19-10.
Yes, and Gavin Wanganeen, a strong bump there on Starsvich to get the footy. And this bad bounce, they've gone mainly Collingwood's way today. With luck featuring, or favouring, I should say, Essendon on this occasion. And Salmon unselfishly the long. And a good finish off.
17, 13, 19, 10. Essendon still with a chance. No free kick to Collingwood. Yes, it is. Had to be. Lehman in the centre. 4 minutes remaining. It's really been a superior game. To Stasevich, who's been terrific. To half forward, Morwin and Thompson. Free kick to Thompson.
Hanging on.
23 kicks Thompson's had. Surprising. O'Donnell's been very good. Orr swings it wide. A good bounce needed. Harvey goes to ground. May have injured himself. Francis, good tackle on Russell, though. And O'Donnell didn't have the footy. Russell over the top. Now Francis, caught by McMullen. What a contest that was for half a minute or so.
And what a critical slip by Mark Harvey, too. The ball didn't sit up for him. I appreciate that. What a time to slip again.
Thought he might have hurt himself when he went
to
ground.
He looked a bit that way, didn't he?
I think he's okay. Essendon needs something clean from this. Chris Danaher couldn't take it. Buick can't take it. Russell, free kick to Essendon, to O'Donnell. Now they've got to move for him. Swings it to Harvey. Cramped up in the end with his kick to centre half forward Stasevic. Long, well played. Sporn, caught, couldn't get away. Grenfell, Sporn, should kick it to Wanganeen. Wanganeen, a great mark. Long's running for him. And Salmon, what will Wanganeen do? Will he go for the goal?
He should just get it up there as quick as he can, Bruce. Set it up there.
Could kick it, you know. Could kick this for sure. Doesn't, kicks it badly, and wastes the chance.
Can you ask, tell me one thing? When he kicked that ball in, Essendon had one player in the goal square. The ball drops short, there's no one there but Salmon. It's unbelievable, the lack of thinking on some of the players at a vital time. There's Wanganeen off the ground. Oh, just bounced before the line. Now, time clock. 2 minutes and 12 seconds of play left in this match. Essendon would have to get a quick goal from this forward thrust. Salmon at the back, tries to grab it out. Sporn trying to get it on to... Ooh, the umpire blew the whistle very quickly and the ball was clear. But still, it's not easy to see where the ball was. I suppose the players at their back. Now, Salmon again. Oh, is that a free kick? I think... Oh, don't tell me. I cannot believe... Did you see that, Russ?
Yes, I saw that.
Was there a free kick there?
Yeah, there was.
Who against?
Salmon.
Well, I tell you what, I couldn't see it.
Stasevic, the halfback. Harvey at the back. Off one leg. Salmon under the footy. Three Collingwood players trying to raffle. Grenfell couldn't get clear. Tries to break a tackle. Is caught. Play on call. Still Stasevic to Rowe, to Krasiska. Collingwood is hanging on. Good kick, Krasiska. Missed by Williams. A little over-anxious. Well played, though. Brilliantly done to Christian. We're inside a minute. And surely now Collingwood will hang on. Francis, left foot. Kick it versus Dacos. Oh, well played, kick it. He's been magnificent. Harvey, O'Donnell, spawns the pass. Now, will it sit? It doesn't. He's caught, and once again, Essendon make a mess of what looked a good opportunity. McGuan swings it wide to Richardson, who goes at the boundary line, and Collingwood is going to win a throw.
Just a good handball there by Wright to the voice, but an equally clever tap and spoil by Kickett to the advantage of his teammate at the other end of the ground.
Madden, Morwin over the top. Lehman to half forward, Derek Kickett to Harvey. Less than 10 seconds remaining. Wallace couldn't take it. And that's it. Oh, thrilling game. Collingwood hanging on by the skin of its teeth. 17-13 Essendon, brave in defeat. Collingwood 9.